Okay, I'm back with a new video, and I pulled this card, these two, yesterday, and it's only a matter of time that they find him, and there is some justice. Either they find them and they can figure out who did it, or somebody confesses, because, you know, keeping a secret like that is unbearable. This is one of those cards that indicate time. Not much or not many cards do that. You have the moon, of course, and the stars. But this is a strong card that says something about the near future. So I hope this is right. Now, me crying is absolutely insane. But I sort of get an image of an older lady with short hair who is a little bit overweight and a little chubby. And I see a kitchen with cupboards and shelves with all kinds of stuff in it. Her house isn't too big. I get a number saying 761. That can be a phone number or an ID number or maybe a house number or maybe a license plate or something. So she is gray, she has short hair, she is chubby, overweight, she is crying all the time, she's locked inside the house, she lives alone. I don't hear a dog, but I have a little bit of a feeling that there are chickens around, or birds or something. I don't hear a dog. I was hoping that I would see the gray car, but I didn't. So that's where the crying comes from. And now I figured that out, it's sort of gone. It's a motherly figure, and it can be Matthew's mother, but it can also be the mother of one of the people involved, that either the two ladies or the man confess something to their mom or something. I hope this makes sense. So I don't think it's Matthew's mom. I don't think it's Matthew's wife. I think it's a motherly figure that they confided in. I hope this makes sense. So there is a father around, a fatherly figure, but he isn't really involved, or he doesn't want to be involved. I think he has a beard, but I'm not 100% sure. There is a lawn, a driveway, it's green. It's not like there was a lot of sun and a lot of summer thing going on and everything is yellowish or dried out. I don't see any roses or a front yard or a backyard. It's just a house in a field of some sort. A little fence, not too high. I think I see two horses on the other side of the fence. So that's an image that sort of is stuck in my brain. It's stuck in my mind. And I find shuffling cards very relaxing. It helps me meditate. It helps me relax. It helps me calm down. It helps me focus. So that's what you're hearing. So that's something that I see, and the tears, I think, come from her. And then there is another thing. I'm like, I was working on Sam Sayer's case a long time ago. And there were, you know, search and rescue organizations and people involved with drones and helicopters and search parties and rescue dogs. And in Matthew's case, I'm like, it's like there is literally no action or something. I don't see drones, I don't hear dogs, you know, going around sniffing and looking and running and, you know, trying to pick up a trace or a track or something. And the weird thing is, I still don't have a feeling that he is too far away. But, you know, especially because it was after the winter that he was lost. There was, I think, no reason to not become very active in trying to find him. There was no snow covering the tracks. I don't see any severe signs of flooding or rain or storms or things like that. So there must have been something of his clothing that they could have used, or, you know. So that sort of stresses me out, because I'm like, if you want to find him, of course I will do the best that I can, but you have to, you know, be proactive in trying to find him and locate him and at least drive around or something. Or, but maybe it's because I think it's a small town, maybe 500 people there, maybe less, maybe more, I don't know. I don't understand what's going on. So maybe there is no police there. Maybe it's too remote and too isolated that, you know, it's not really a thing to question people or to do a search or something like that. Because something has to be done. You know, somebody has to, you know, take charge and take control and lead, and, you know, but maybe I really don't understand why I get this passive, not lazy but uninterested or resilient or resisting type of. Maybe it's a very protective community where everybody, you know, maybe it's so remote that people, you know, either let it go or protect each other or something like that. That they solve their issues in their own way without any police involved. But I think Jason sent me a picture of Matthew, some kind of police type of this person is missing thing. But maybe it's just, you know, a thing that they do and leave it at that. Or they're still deciding on what to do or what not to do. But was it March or April that he went missing? And then they just say that he's missing and they're not looking. Or maybe they're waiting till the case solves itself and nobody really has to do any research. I don't know. So, Demonic Angel, if you see this, can you please check in on, tap into or tune into what's going on there? Because I don't feel any action, nothing proactive or somebody has to start this journey. Because if you leave it like this, nothing's going to happen. Nothing's going to happen. But on the other hand, I am hoping that somebody is going to come forward and confess and, you know, there will be justice. It's a very short video, but this is, I just wasn't able to get a clear connection with Matthew today. yesterday it stopped and today it was very hard, very vague, very blurry. So that's for the police, that's for the old or older, not too old lady. Maybe she is Matthew's age, but she looks a little bit older, maybe because she's a little overweight or something, and she just knows what's going on. And maybe I have to just let it go for a week or so and then pick up again. See an ex again. It's not like I'm not shuffling. I'm shuffling, you know, while I'm making this video. And you know how, if I pull that card one more time, I'm going crazy. So this must be it, you know. So what else can I do? I just don't know what to do anymore. I can do a spell for myself to make myself more, you know, powerful and more in tune with Matthew. Maybe he is a hard guy, is a difficult person to talk to. And when you do, you get jokes or something, but I don't know. He is such a friendly soul, you know, so mellow and a little bit of a depression, but I don't get anything aggressive from him at all. Maybe that's just me, but I can't feel any nasty, hateful vibe he's carrying inside. And demonic angel, if you are watching this video, help me out. Maybe you have some input or feedback for me and Jason and Renee. And I just don't understand why I keep picking the same cards over and over and over again. I'm not joking, you know. There are 78 cards in a deck, and if you keep shuffling them, the amount of combinations is endless, limitless. So why am I constantly, but this is a good thing, I think it's just a matter of time, and I'm not joking, you know, it's completely insane why I... this is another one that keeps popping up. This one. This one again. So who is guilty here? Anyway, a short update. I think I will take a break for a couple of days. And then just start fresh. Start over. Do it again. See you next time. Bye.